انا هذه اول زياره عندي في للقاهره، مع عمري زرت القاهره ولا مصر منذ 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 لاول مره ازور القاهره، وانا احب القاهره لان فيها القراء، كثير من القراء في القران، ومنهم الامام ورش الذي نقرا بقراءته في المغرب. أتعرفون هذا؟ ونسميه بالمصري، نقول مره ورش ومره نقول المصري. In my talk today, I have 45 minutes. Okay, I will talk about malware analysis and with quick demo about WannaCry. I think you know all of you. You know WannaCry, I suppose, huh? Not Petya, WannaCry, and other ransomware. And the last one. I think it happens three months ago, I think. So I am I'm working for IBM Security as a security architect, and also at I work also for IBM Labs as a researcher in AppSec, in different area in security. And I am also chapter leader of Morocco, and I manage with Mohamed the AppSec Africa. We made two events in Morocco, this year in Egypt, next year in Morocco, and maybe in other countries for the future, inshallah. So we'll discuss malware analysis with GHIDRA. Do you know the GHIDRA tool? Do you have some experience about on malware analysis? Who has experience on malware analysis? Reverse engineering? Okay. A lot of people work with reverse engineering and malware analysis using a tool called IDEA. IDEA Pro, it depends. It is expensive tool. A lot of people doing malware analysis, they use I don't know which copy they have, but it's not the licensed one. In RSI conference, NSA delivered a good tool called GHIDRA. I will show you some quick malware analysis of WannaCry with this tool. I will go quick in some definition. You know, malware is malicious software. In some case, they make some it is dangerous software. During penetration testing talk, during our pen testing task for our customer, we put what we call goodware. It's not malware, it's goodware. Because we need to prove that we entered the system, because as penetration tester, you need to enter. It's the reason why you need to know how to, a penetration tester need to know malware analysis, how the tool and techniques. And the required skills, you need to know assembly language. Assembly language in for Intel, and assembly language for ARM, ARM microprocessor. Without good knowledge of assembly language, it's very, very difficult to make malware analysis. Okay, so I will go quick in because I need to make some demo. This definition is a lot of you don't know, but you need to know that malware can have in his payload virus, worm, trojan, rootkit, and other malicious software. In the same malware, we can have different payload. Okay, and during the analysis, we need to understand what happened. Why malware analysis increases, the spreading of malware increases, because people, a lot of people, IT people, experienced people, you continue to click. When you receive PDF file, executable file, any link, you click, automatically you click. It's the reason why you need to remember, never click, don't click. Actually, everybody, if I send this presentation in PPTX or PDF file to anybody, you click. And when you click, you open the file, in the domain gene of the browser. You know that a lot of antivirus software and point protection didn't scan the DOM engine zone in the browser. And the malware can execute himself in this zone and after infect your computer. And the reason why, never click, don't click. We repeat this to a lot of people during the awareness session, don't click, don't click. And after we can send email, you win some prize, something like that. Please click here to receive your prize. People click. If you repeat click, lot of time. Don't click, lot of time. So you know that the reason of increase that we are lot of computer, people are not trained correctly. People behavior is the reason why actually in cybersecurity we have some course called the human, secure the human, because we can secure computer, we can secure everything, but we cannot secure the human. It's very, very difficult to change our behavior. The reason why malware can increase himself, every time we heard about malware infection in different area, in different zone. Okay, thank you. I will give you the slide, but I'm not here to read the slide. I just show you some definition, but I prefer to explain something, to explain the slide. Okay. It's very important to define some definition about malware. So here we can read some definition here. We have some definition here. We have, for example, some of you, they know what does it backdoor. Okay, and the tool we'll use during this demonstration is called GHIDRA. The first version delivered delivered by NSA for download contain backdoor. Is the reason why if you need to use GHIDRA, I recommend you to always go to the GitHub and compile the program after analyzing the source code in Java, because GHIDRA is Java, is written in Java. Don't use binary file directly, okay? So you know the definition of vulnerability, you know the definition of what does it mean homogeneity, and what does it mean to drive by download. And all of these are the ways of spreading malware in IT system, in internet, etc. You know the definition of zero day. You know that zero day is not really zero day. It's maybe 1 year, 2 year. Actually, we are doing, at IBM, we are doing a lot of search of malware, of bug vulnerability for a lot of customer. We know a lot of bug, but we never disclose them. But when the customer disclose the event, we are researcher, we know this vulnerability, and some malicious hacker, they know also the same vulnerability because we use the same tool. And zero day mean that there is the exploit, the vulnerability is undisclosed, and the some malicious hacker, they know this vulnerability, they can exploit it without publishing this vulnerability. You know the term exploit. The exploit is how to if the vulnerability exists, and we use some code like shell code, etc. And we use the exploit to exploit this vulnerability to use this vulnerability to enter to the system. In general, the exploits can be generated by bug or by flaws. Okay. You know the term privilege escalation, the term evasion, and the term blended threat. Okay. You can ask if you have some, but this is most definition. Here we have some other definition here. Okay. So. And the list is not exhaustive. We have lot of term, and this list is use CISCP standard term. So it is our terminology. We use it in our report and different different talks. Because we will I will show you demo about WannaCry. I will give you some history of ransomware. Ransomware is a class of malware used to block the system and ask you to pay. Okay, when you click, if you click, or sometimes you receive some attack by using USB case, something like that. Your system will be infected, and they ask you to pay. Some ransomware they ask you to pay ransom. Some of them they encrypt data, and they ask you to pay to decrypt data, etc. etc. You know the example of WannaCry, NotPetya. There is lot of example of ransomware, and we'll see here during this this picture some history. The first ransomware is called Ads Trojan, was published in 1989. Me, I start to work in security, IT security in 1997. And I got my PhD in 1991. IP exists only in some university in the United States and not in the enterprise. There is no internet exists, but small, very, very small. In 2005, we have this malware. This is really the first ransomware. In 2011, we have this Trojan. We have no name here. And after we start with the ransomware who crypt data called CryptoLocker. And this technique was used by different ransomware later in the next slide, for example. We have crypto defense, crypto wall, etc. We have also some ransomware called Locker. The means of the ransomware, they lock your computer, they ask you to pay. If you pay, you are not sure to recover your data. The reason why, if you lost your data because you was infected by ransomware, don't pay. Try to restore from a safe backup, or say bye-bye to your data, because a lot of people, they can backup, because a lot of company, they backup, but they never test restore. Because backup, they say, oh, backup is working. But what happened with restore? Can you restore your database? Can you restore your data? Is the reason why they are DRP, etc., etc. So there is only one solution, is to have good backup and restore solution. And if you are infected, you reset your computer, you restore your data. There is good product in open source and commercial product. Okay, I will go quick in this history. I don't want to cry here. You know WannaCry and different WannaCry and NotPetya. They are the most really. They use SMB. You know SMB is protocol used by Windows. We have two versions, version 1 and version 2. Lot of people they have last version of Windows and old version of Windows like Windows XP. I saw in some company. Okay. Lot of company they have old version of Windows, new version of Windows. Because they have old version of Windows, they keep SMB v1. Is the reason why WannaCry and NotPetya they spread themselves quickly in the company, because they use old version of SMB. SMB is a protocol used by Microsoft, created by Tricom in 1992. It's old protocol. So I will go directly to the GHIDRA, because I don't have enough time. I'm sorry. So GHIDRA is this person present in the RSI conference 2019, the tool created by NSA called GHIDRA. They put this tool as open source tool. It's very, very good tool. And we use it from because GHIDRA was published by WikiLeaks link, you know WikiLeaks link. Now it is officially open source. We can download the source from GitHub. You can compile it. I recommend you to compile the program. Don't use the binary downloaded from NSA. Because there is one, I give you one rule, don't click. I give you another rule, don't trust. Never trust. If I say, if someone send you some program, some executable, etc., analyze what you, if you have good endpoint protection, it's good for you. But don't trust input, user input, company input, what you want, don't trust. So GHIDRA is a very, very good tool. It is like ADA Pro. And with future, with the commercial future, it's very, very good tool. It was disclosed in 2017 by this Vault 7 leak disclosure by WikiLeaks. And we start to use it in starting from this year because we access to the binary. We use the binary in sandbox machine, not directly in our machine because we have only binary. So you can use it. You have the GitHub link here. If you need to download, you type GHIDRA in Google. You will find directly this link. It's equivalent to this program. We use GHIDRA for reverse engineering. The reverse engineering, we have only the binary. We load the binary program to the GHIDRA and we access to all function in binary code. It's in general assembly language. And we can start analysis of this binary code. Okay, we have this definition of reverse engineering. GHIDRA is really easy tool. The installation is easy. So the good. I have some screen here, but I will make directly the demo. It's better. Okay. And after you can take my screen and repeat the demo by yourself if you want. It's not difficult. And to do demo, I will do it with WannaCry ransomware. Okay. So for demo, I prepared some VM called Remunix. It's VM used for malware analysis. I recommend you to use this VM, but I can recommend you another tool called CuckooBox. It's a really good sandbox box, but CuckooBox is used for automated malware analysis. Okay, if you start with malware analysis, start with this is easy, and after when you acquire some experience, you can go to the automated. Okay, so. Let me, okay, when I will put this like this, so I can play here. So it's easy for me. So I will close the program. Okay, I can this is my shell. I can go to root because it's just a demo. But if you have doing malware analysis in sandbox, because this PC is completely sandboxed, it is is big. It's because this one contains 32 processors, 64 gigabits. It's a like server. We use it for our demo for it's also sandbox. But if you are doing in your PC. I really recommend you to use VMware sandbox, using VirtualBox, VMware, what you want. So I use a small password. It's not. I have here when you download the GHIDRA, you have here this directory. I go to this directory. It's and after you have binary file here. You type this. And you will get a full screen here. This is the last version. Okay. If you are analyzing Windows malware, it is safe to analyze Windows malware in a Linux machine as sandbox, because the Windows the malware cannot execute it himself. But if you are analyzing rootkit, rootkit is malware designed for Unix-like. You need to pay more attention, and you need to have good good sandbox. So you can see here, it's, when you start, I have this screen. With GHIDRA, it's easy. You go to the. Let me. It's really easy. You go to the home folder, download, and I have the malware here. WannaCry, that easy. If I can, I have a Windows machine, but if I run it in Windows machine, the machine will be infected immediately. I can. You make this. You drop file. You drag and drop the file. Before, you need to create project. Sorry. You can create project, not shared or shared project. If you have team doing malware analysis, you can create shared project. So you can start malware, stop. Someone can continue and continue the analysis, etc. I can give any name, for example, demo. My keyboard is French keyboard. And after, you can see here, when I drag the file, I have here, it is P executable. This means that it is Windows file. It's not Linux. You have the name here. I click on OK. GHIDRA starts to import the file, and you have all information here about this file. You can see that the file is a 32-bit program. X84 is 32, you can see here. You have the minimum address and the maximum address start, and you have the number of bytes. You have the name. It is Windows program, and you have a lot of information. And you can see that GHIDRA try to load the DLL because it is Unix machine. There is no DLL. You cannot load. If you need, it is not interesting to load the DLL because we don't need this for malware analysis. Okay, and. After I click on OK, if I click on the file, if I click on the project, I will get this screen. GHIDRA, when you start at first time, ask you to analyze the program. You can do it. You can skip this, but I recommend you to analyze this program. But at the beginning, if you are analyzing Windows file, 32 or 64, you need to enable some parameters like this one, the compiler parameter ID, and there is another option. You need to enable this other option here, this one. Because we are analyzing Windows, we need to propagate the external function, and we click. Okay. So when we click, we get this, and you can see here, it is we have an error because the program don't contain debug information, because the malicious hacker will not infect people with malware with debug information. So we don't need this for analysis. It's not. And what does it when we get I don't have it, how many time I have, Mohammed? 10 minutes. Okay. When you start here, it's you can see here you have the binary you hidden. You need to look to two things. Function. The first one is function. And any C program in Windows or in Linux, they have what we call main function. Okay, you need to look to this main function, the listen function and main function. You can see here, I have here this one. And I can see I have lot of function here. But if we look here, there is no main function. Okay? This means that the attacker who creates this program didn't use main function. He used other things. In some program, you will sometime, if it is Windows, you will find win main. W uppercase, M uppercase, win main. Sometime you will find main. Here we don't have main, but we can see we have entry here. We have no main. No, we have no main function here, but we have entry. Okay. Let me click on this one. If I have main function, it's good. But okay, this is my entry function. Start from I can see here the compiled version of entry function. You can see this is the GHIDRA decompiled the function in readable language. It's a C. You can see. And what I need to look this function. This entry function, it's the start of my program. Program starts from this one. I can see here, you can see here, it starts with some stack here. And we can look to the compiled version of the function here. It is small, not really. But what I need to search in this one is the call for other function. You can see this entry function called lot of function here. It's difficult to look to this code and try to understand which function is called, which one is called, which one. GHIDRA give a really interesting function present in IDEA Pro. I don't know who use who in this room who has the experience with IDEA Pro. You can use good function here in Windows. You click on Windows menu here. And you have what we call function call graph. And you have, I will try to. Let me return here. And you. Hopla. You can see here you have the entry function. So this is the program starts here. You call all this function during malware analysis session. Malware analysis session is not guess. Malware analysis and reverse engineering is a science. You need to understand what you are doing. You need to understand the binary language, assembly language, etc. So you have different function called here. During the malware analysis, what I need to do? What is what is the next step? Do you have any idea here in this room? More programs from here. In some time I have win main, sometime I have mail. What I need to do after? But to do after, because you can see here, you have this function, this one, this one, this one, this one, this one. A lot of malware, they use vulnerable protocol like SMB, like FTP, etc. And they need to communicate with the malware commander, is the malicious hacker tool to command the malware. So this malware, they will use some protocol like FTP, like HTTP, etc. So we need to look for in each function which protocol is used. Okay. We need to search. It's like digging. We need to go function by function, but looking for something interesting, like FTP protocol. Yes. I thank you. We call this the kill switch. If we find this, I'm coming to say it, but it's okay. This kill switch, we need to find this kill switch, because if we find it, we can understand what happened. And after, in WannaCry, we did the. I don't have time to show you a lot of because I can. I have Windows machine. We can infect Windows machine with some file, and I can show you how to find the decryption key directly by doing malware analysis. We don't have time, but during the first, we find the kill switch, which protocol we are using, which server we are communicating with the server. Sometime if you have some PC infected in your computer, in your IT, and you know which protocol is used, maybe you can stop the propagation, you can stop the spread. Sometime it's during the WannaCry infection, a lot of people don't understand it is SMB v1. They block the some communication with the server, because a lot of companies like Symantec, McAfee, they publish the link, which because the WannaCry communicate with this server, with this HTTP link, but then they don't block the SMB v1, and the propagation continue internally. And you know, internally, a lot of companies, they don't have what we call virtual firewall in the architecture. They don't have segmentation, etc., etc. Okay, so let's look to, I don't know which function, but it is small, maybe. Okay, choose the first one. So, the first one. If I click on the first one here, let me close this. I can see only I have return. Really not interesting. Okay, go to the call graph. Let's take this. Here it's I have something maybe interesting. I can see here that he called something called the control FTP, control FP, and I have return. During your malware analysis session, when we find something interesting, I recommend you, because you cannot remember this function with this name, I recommend you to give a name. You can remember this name, you can give any name. I don't know which name, but look to this, something interesting, what happened, etc. So you can remember. Okay. Keep this. To remember this function, it's not difficult. Just with GHIDRA, you go here. You click on button right. You go to the function. And you click on rename. Doing the rename function with this methodology will rename function in all the code generated by GHIDRA. Okay, if you rename the function into the compile screen, it will not rename in all the code. Okay, you can, for example, look any name. For example, I can. Can see if I rename it, it is renamed everywhere. Okay, so you can see here also. And after I can return to my, and I will continue my analysis. If I go to this one, I can see here. I can see if I go to this, if I click to this, I don't have it, I have mouse, but I don't have space to put the mouse. So it's difficult without. So return to the entry. And look to another function, okay? Maybe this one is interesting because this one call other function. And we continue to dig until we find our kill switch. And after, when we find our kill switch, we can go to the another next step. Mohammed, how many time? I will stop here because if I continue, I need to continue more. If you have some question, you can ask. We have 5 minutes because I don't have time to show you. This is a really, really quick introduction to malware analysis. If you want, we have next in October. I will run a full hands-on session in Ireland in ISF in Internet Security Forum. We call ISF Congress in Dublin. You can register and come if you want. Yes.
In this case, we had seen a code. It seems coming from C or C++ programming language. If you are talking about program or an executable, depending on a framework, something like C sharp, depending on .NET framework, how would be analysis?
Because the compiler is looking C++, but it is a C, it's not C++.
It's C, but actually, as we all know, C and C++ runs directly on the processors. So actually, we can illustrate the function call graph, the instructions clearly defined, which we saw the variables declarations, the entry or main functions, and other parameters. Okay? You are talking about another type of programming language that dependent on a framework, something like C sharp executable. So actually, it's not calling the processor.
GHIDRA, when GHIDRA decompile, it decompile only in this format. It cannot decompile in C-sharp or Python, something like that. But for me, if I wrote a lot of goodware for our pen testing mission, I never use C-sharp or other language. We use a lot of malicious hacker. They use C or assembly language. Some of them, if they have the commander, we call this the command to control the malware, we can use C-sharp, PHP, any other language. But the malware itself, it needs to be small, very, very small, because the payload must be very, very small. And to write a small footprint, there is only two languages, C or assembly.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, a question here. I will give you the slide so you can continue this.
Well, my question is actually two-part. One of them is actually responding to his question regarding C-sharp and .NET. The GHIDRA tool will do exactly like you said, but in this time, especially in this type of framework, especially .NET, if it's not ahead of time compiled, you're going to actually see in GHIDRA the code for the framework itself, not your own executable. Exactly. So, as you said, it's going to try to reverse the framework because the entire code is in a middle language, MIL, so you had to wait until it actually executes to see what's actually executing, but it's going to be inside the runtime, step by step. You cannot even see the entire exe. So that's the first part of my question. The second part is, GHIDRA is an NSA tool, and how much I can depend on it while I fully trust what it gonna do? It gonna not collect anything. I know it's open source, we can review it, but it's still a trust issue.
This is a good question. I recommend you to have your to have a toolkit with different tool, not only GHIDRA.
Yeah, so it's gonna be like
one tool is not enough.
One tool, yeah.
One exactly. Tool is not enough. For example, this is what we did in the static analysis. If you use dynamic analysis, is other tool. If you use automated analysis, I recommend you to use CocoaBox. CocoaBox embed lot of interesting tool. And during, if you need to be good malware analyzer, you need to have a different tool, good toolbox.
Okay. Last question for me. What are we going to do with the new language? What do you recommend with new language? Something like Go and all the new language like Ruby on Rails and stuff like this. All of these languages are, in fact, C-based and C++-based. But still, there's some hope I can see faster analysis if I try a sort of an equal preview for this language as a higher level. It great my reversing. Is there a way or a tool or a plugin that helps this new trend of languages that are high performant but based on C and C++?
For example, for GHIDRA, they have a plugin. You can use a different language to add some plugin. You can use Ruby, you can use Python, etc., etc. So the I don't know how you can answer your question. it's not easy. But for me, good malware analyzer. I don't know who person who try to work on malware analysis need first to learn assembly language C and C++.
Yeah, that's for sure. Yeah.
Okay. This is.
This is the mastery level. That's
this
right.
is
yeah,
the,
yeah.
the we call yeah. this the foundation.
Yeah.
And after, I recommend to learn Python. Why? Because a lot of security people in the world they use Python. Python is not really easy language to use, not to learn. It's easy to learn because you have tabulation, etc., etc. But because there is a lot of library using Python existing in GitHub, you can use them directly. But I recommend you to learn more than Python, because Python is scripting language. You can learn Python, you can use Ruby, Perl, etc. But you need to have this toolkit. And malware analysis is really time consuming. If you start malware, sometimes they took for us 5 days, 1 week, 3 weeks. It depends, and must be included in the process of what we call the security operation center. You need know that a lot of companies they start security operation center. They have some SOC analysts, malware analysts, etc. This must be included in this process, and the malware analyst must have this knowledge.
Thank you.
We have, for information, I have a good open source course about malware analysis. I can give you the link. Perfect. We have thousands of slides. You can learn with different tool, open source tool. I use GHIDRA, but we have licensed the version. But in our open source course, we use open source tool, not licensed tool. So I can share this course with you if you want.
Perfect.
No problem. Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you so much.